What you are looking at is an ongoing eruption of New Zealand's infamous White Island volcano, courtesy of footage by the Extreme Pursuit and Geoff Mackley YouTube channels. This eruption, which began on August 9th, is now on its fifth day and is still going strong. All of these ash emissions are originating from a small 3-meter or 9.8-foot-wide vent adjacent to one of its more explosion craters which formed during the deadly 2019 eruption. In other words, this erupting vent could be described as an ash jet. So, why is it pulsating rather than being completely continuous? My educated guess is that because so much rising gas and ash is present, its presence can cause a weak plug to momentarily form on the erupting vent, causing gas to build up in pressure until it overcomes the overlying gas and ash, causing it to be pushed away in the next batch to rise. This process is occurring about once a second, causing a plume of ash and gases to rise to an altitude of 1,524 meters or 5,000 feet. This meager height and the visible phreatic eruptive activity is consistent with a medium-end VEI-1 explosive eruption, but to be sure, it is best to figure out how much material is erupting in this video clip every second. If we assume that the rising eruption column initially has a density of 80 kilograms per cubic meter, and since we can observe the cloud initially rising at a rate of 3 meters every second, this leads me to estimate that 2.077 cubic meters of ash is erupting every second. This translates to a volume approximately 6,000 times less than White Island's 2019 eruption, which only lasted 2 minutes, and if you combine this with the height of the plume, it suggests the ongoing eruption has a volcanic explosivity index of a 1. However, this ongoing less intense eruption does appear to be slowly waning, despite the fact it now represents White Island's longest eruption since 2013. Yet, while continuous activity has become a bit more intermittent with spurts of ash emissions, hence the falling particles in these webcam photos, this development might be misleading. While, yes, the eruption could actively be waning before its eventual cessation, there is another possibility, one I might add, which is supported by recent gas emissions observed originating from the White Island volcano. These gas emissions showed a notable increase in sulfur dioxide emissions, and since sulfur dioxide emissions of this level can only indicate the presence of shallow magma, this means that magma has ascended to depths of less than 500 meters when it would normally be situated at twice that depth underground. In other words, the decline in eruptive activity could be due to rising magma blocking part of the conduit to the surface, meaning we soon may have a true magmatic eruption on our hands, which could even get a full magnitude more explosive. Although there is some evidence that White Island's 2019 eruption had a magmatic component to it, there is no direct evidence that a strong magmatic eruption rather than a phreatic one occurred on White Island since 2012, when a small 30-meter-wide andesite lava dome was emplaced. If another magmatic eruption was to occur, pyroclastic flows and stronger volcanian eruptions will become likely, and this could cause regional disruptions to air traffic via taller and more widespread eruption plumes. As a final note, I would like to thank my patron Rob for upgrading their membership tier to this channel via our Patreon page.